Okay, so this is the next part in participants' perception. This is the second part, which is to inquire about the participants' negative perception. So this part, we will discuss the findings on several challenges faced by the participants in employing WOW in vocabulary learning. There are four items in the interview question which correspond to negative perception. And then the items were designed based on the participant responses in a survey for research question one just now. Okay, these items were used to discuss the participants' agreement on the negatively perceived elements of WOW, such as the distracting background music, unchallenging games, and the leaderboard, which affected the participants' concentration, motivation, and drive to use WOW in vocabulary learning. So again, I have marked participant responses and put it and summarize it in a table. So for first item, the statement is the music distracts me while I am answering questions. Question 2, some games are too easy and not challenging for me. Item 3, lack of confidence, which I am not confident to use WOW to learn vocabulary. And lastly, item 4, I prefer WOW as a class activity than homework. Okay, so firstly, the researcher asked the participants if they have been distracted by the background of music in WOW while using it, and a few of the participants acknowledged the difficulties. A participant mentioned that she felt disturbed by the background music as it distracts them when they were answering the questions. So this is from participant 8 response. I think that it distracts me a little bit when the music is too loud. Okay, also in a racing game, the upbeat music may be too loud for the participants to focus. This is from participant 3. Sometimes the music is too loud and I lost focus. While participant 1 claimed that the audio is still quite loud despite lowering the volume. So participant 1 mentioned that she likes the listening to music, but sometimes it is loud even though I have decreased the volume. Okay, participant 5 next stated that some games are uninteresting because it's quite boring, like for example matching and true and false game, because it's too easy. The researcher then asked the participants to recall the game that is least interesting for them. Two of the participants mentioned crossword puzzle, while others do not recall. They also agreed that crossword puzzle being a non-favorite. Okay, and then this is supported by the analysis of the game summaries obtained from the Word Wall web. The researcher observed that many of the participants only attempted the crossword puzzle games once. So this is contradicting with other examples of game summaries, because for other games, most of the participants will retry at least 2 times. For crossword puzzle, most of them barely made it to finish and only attempted the games once. So I did mention that some of the participants obtained low marks but did not retry the game, unlike other games where the participant retried multiple times. So according to participant 6, crossword puzzle is uninteresting because it is mostly words and it doesn't have pictures. So this is agreeable because the layout of crossword puzzle doesn't allow pictures to be added in the questions. And then participant 2 also mentioned that crossword puzzle is the least favorite because it's an ordinary game. She mentioned that I have played it multiple times before, it is not interesting. So crossword puzzle is not something new. They have experience using crossword puzzle, and to have it in games is not interesting enough for them. Other participants also mentioned that she do not like find the parts where they had to open each card that is put face down and match pictures with the vocabulary. So I have included the screenshot of a crossword puzzle game example. This is the crossword puzzle and this is find the pairs, where the students have to find each pair of the game. Okay, the next item inquired whether the participants were confident in using WOW to learn vocabulary. And then the participants responded that they did not fully agree with the statement in item 2, which is whether they have confidence in using WOW. So they did not fully agree, which means they do have confidence, but also sometimes also sometimes they don't have the confidence. Okay, participant 3 discussed that he did not feel confident in using WOW in certain topics, where he found that the words are more challenging than the others. Okay, so sometimes the vocabulary are confusing because I was confused with some words which has a similar meaning but different pictures, like destruction and destroyed. This is according to participant 3, while participant 7 mentioned that most words are easy but some are challenging. And then when he doesn't understand the words, he will not be confident with his marks. While participant 2 discussed how the leaderboard undermines her confidence, I do not have good English mastery, so I feel nervous to see my rank on the list. Okay, next one, participant 9 agreed that he would prefer using WOW together as a class activity instead of independently at home. So this, quite a number of the participants agreed. For example, participants say that it would be more interesting to use WOW with friends in the presence of the teacher to give direct guidance when there are problems. This is mentioned participant 9 response. Playing in class might be better than playing alone because I can ask questions directly to the teacher. I think it's more fun to play in class with friends too. Other participants also agreed, in which participant 4 mentioned that it's better to play in class. I can ask teachers for help. And I am more confident when learning with teacher because teacher can give clues for the question. And then participant 7 mentioned that teacher can give guidance if you use WOW in class together. When teacher explains, I can remember the words better. Okay, so based on the responses, the researcher assumed that the participants have been dependent on the teacher with their learning, thus are more comfortable in using WOW in the teacher's vicinity. The researcher concludes that some of the participants might struggle with the lack of direct assistance from the teacher while using WOW independently at home. Therefore, the suggestion to use WOW in class as well as an independent learning tool should be considered in the future. Okay, lastly, this is the third research question. How does WOW assist pupils in their vocabulary learning? So in order to answer research question 3, since this is a quantitative research question, a series of pre and post tests were conducted to assess whether there is any improvement in pupils' vocabulary learning. Data is collected through a series of pre and post tests. And then the researcher conduct pre and post tests after introducing the vocabulary for each unit in formal lessons. The gap between the formal vocabulary learning and pre-test is 5 days on average. So at first, the vocabulary is introduced in a class activity. So it will be a normal learning in class session. And then there will be a pre-test, which is after five days of learning. And then after scores for pre-test were collected, the participants were asked to complete the games in WOW. The participants were also given several days to access the game to use WOW, and then the post-test were carried out after a period of time, usually after a week, or the least is 5 days. To avoid the participants focusing on the vocabulary to do well on the post-test, the participants were not informed of the significance of any of the tests carried out. The participants were informed that the worksheets were a part of their revision. So they do not know that they were not informed, and they were that the tests were pre and post tests. So in pre and post tests, participants were tested on several things. For example, the spelling of the new words introduced, the association of pictures, as well as applying the vocabulary in sentences. The topics for each unit are as follow: Unit 1, Family Day. Unit 2, saving, sharing and spending. For unit 3, we have superheroes. Unit 6, self-protection. Unit 7, the king's decision. And unit 11 is about natural disasters. So this is a figure that summarizes briefly the pre and post results. The study, based on this graph, it is found that there is a significant improvement in scores between the pre and post tests. This is the some the results of a sample t-test, which which display the mean and standard deviation of each pre and post test, and then the mean difference, the standard deviation, the T, and also significant P. So generally, post-test scores of the significance of the participants increase after using WOW in vocabulary learning. The value of means for post-test in unit 1 to unit 8 is higher than their pre-test. It shows that vocabulary scores improve after the participants use WOW in vocabulary learning. Unit 1 has the highest mean in the pre-test, while the lowest mean in pre-test is unit 6 with mean 1.90. It shows that the participants were more likely to struggle with answering pre-test in unit 6. In contrast, most of the participants scored a high mark in pre-test for unit 1, as the language and many vocabularies used in unit 1 are familiar and more straightforward, as it is the first topic introduced in year 5. Based on the researcher's field notes, the researcher also noted that the vocabulary used in unit 1 are mostly familiar to the participants. The participants showed a quick understanding when introduced to the vocabulary in unit 1. The vocabulary in unit 1 are related to family's day, for example, excited, balloon, contest, which are more familiar in comparison to unit 6 vocabulary, which is related to self-protection. For example, grab, threaten, and demand. I compared the mean value for post-test, which is the highest mean value is unit 11, and also the lowest mean for post-test is also unit 6. The difference in the values of means show that majority of the participants achieve high scores in unit 11 post-test. The topic natural disasters in this unit received positive response from the participants, as described in the researchers' field notes. A couple of statements obtained from the interview's transcriptions were also in favor of the topic. Participant 7 mentioned, "I remember the topic the most. It's my favorite topic. We learned the words in class and also used the same words in the game." While participant 3 mentioned, "When I answer a quiz about natural disasters, I was excited." So when these participants mentioned about the topic, the several others agreed that the topic was quite memorable for them. Other than that, the summary of the game results obtained from World War Web supported that participants showed positive responses to the topic. So I have completed a screenshot of the game summary from the World War website. It recorded the highest number of participants, which is 54 over 60. And then in comparison to other unit, this is the highest number of students who participate in this activity. On the other hand, unit 6 has the lowest mean. Unit 6 has the lowest mean value for post-test. The improvement of scores in participants' marks was relatively low compared to the other units in WOW. However, unit 6 also recorded the most significant mean difference between its pre- and post-test. Okay, so as described in the table, the improvement in scores between each unit pre- and post-test are significant. The average mean differences of all units are 5.10, which is considerably high. Other than that, the p-value for each unit, which is less than 0.05, is significant. Thus, the null hypothesis is rejected. Okay, so far, this is what I have for my data. And I am not quite satisfied with this, the third research questions yet, but I will work on it later. And I would like to thank you, Doctor, for if you have any...